Do you think there's an afterlife?
Yeah.
Do you ever think about it?
Sometimes.
Are you afraid of death?
No.
If you're standing on a freeway and there's an 18-wheeler heading for you, would you try and get out of the way?
Of course. I mean, I'm not suicidal.
So the reason I gave the illustration is to say if there was a way for you to get out of death hitting you head on, would you be interested?
Yeah, of course.
Do you believe in God's existence?
Yeah.
Why is that?
I don't know. Because, I mean, if it came from somewhere, it's got to be something out there, you know? If there's this big bang somewhere, like, someone has to make that, you know?
Do you think God's happy with you as a person?
Maybe not, but I'll
find
out.
Some things that are wrong?
Maybe.
You've lied and stolen?
Sometimes.
Have you used his name as a cuss word?
Occasionally.
Jesus said, if you look at a woman and lust for her, you commit adultery with her in your heart. Have you ever looked at a woman with lust?
Every day.
So, I'm not judging you, Joey, but you've just told me you're a lying, thieving, blasphemous adulterer at heart. If God judges you by the Ten Commandments on Judgment Day, you're going to be innocent or guilty?
I'd like to say I'd get into heaven.
Well, the Bible says all liars have their part in the lake of fire. No thief, no fornicator, no adulterer. Have you had sex out of marriage?
Of course. But, I mean, God forgives, you know, that's the whole thing.
So if you believe
he's there, you know, you'll accept him into your heart.
Let me tell you what the Bible says and then see if you agree, okay? If you died in your sins, you've got God's promise you'd end up in hell. But 2,000 years ago, because God is rich in mercy, he sent a Savior. God became a human being, Jesus of Nazareth, who suffered and died on the cross to take the punishment for the sin of the world. You and I broke God's law, the Ten Commandments, they're called the moral law. Jesus came and paid the fine. If you're in court and someone pays the fine, the judge can let you go. He can say, Joey's guilty, but someone's paid his fine. He's out of here. Well, God can legally commute your death sentence. He can dismiss your court case. He can let you live forever because of that death on the cross. Jesus cried out, it is finished, just before he died, which means the debt has been paid. And now, because of the death and resurrection of the Savior, God can grant you everlasting life. He can let you live. But you don't need to ask Jesus into your heart. You need to repent. Turn from sin and trust in Jesus for your eternal salvation, like you trust a parachute. You don't just believe in a parachute.
I mean, how can you trust a parachute?
Well, yeah, a lot of people trust parachutes and the parachute lets them down. You know, that gets twisted and they die. But God will never let you down. The Bible says he is faithfully promised. So does this make sense what I'm saying?
Yeah, you know, it does. But I'd like to think even with, you know, the fear of death, we got a long life, so I'll cross that bridge when I get there, you know. Like, when it's my time to settle back and sit down and repent, then I'll do that. And
do you know how many people die every day?
A ton.
150,000. This is tremendously urgent. You don't realize this, but I love you, I care about you, and the thought of you ending up in hell horrifies me. There was a guy in the Bible like you. He says, I'll get right with God when I want to. And Jesus said, you fool, tonight your soul is required of you. So don't be a fool. You know, realize how precious your life is to you. Jesus said, what shall it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? So God might just snuff you out before your plans come to pass. He does that. Genesis 38, God killed a man because he didn't like what he did sexually. In the book of Acts, he killed a husband and wife because they told one lie. So let the fear of God come into your heart, because the Bible says through the fear of the Lord.
I fear God all the time, but I mean,
you use his name as a cuss word.
Yeah.
That's not fearing God.
I don't think that he can't just smite me down with a lightning bolt or but
he can, but he's rich in mercy and he's given you a chance to repent. So
that's why I, you know, believe in him and accept it in my heart. And
you need to repent and trust Christ, because at the moment you're heading for hell, I want to see you saved. So get before the Lord, confess and forsake your sins, as the Bible says, trust in Jesus and you'll pass from death to life. Does it make sense?
Yeah.
You have a Bible at home?
Somewhere.
You're going to think about what we talked about?
Yeah, of course.
Appreciate that. Thanks for talking to me, Joey.
Yeah, no problem.